where some of his friends go and carry out pranks against the headmaster. And this boy has observed them doing it. And he's from a very mediocre family. He's on a scholarship in the school. And yet, under pressure from the principal, he does not give the names of the three boys who actually carried out the prank. You must see that book, movie, Scent of a Woman. It's fantastic. So it teaches you that your loyalty towards your peers, towards your organization, towards the school that you come from, must be foremost. Next. Leading by personal example. When you're a leader, you have to do things correctly. You have to be disciplined. You have to be punctual. You have to be smart. You have to be good in whatever you are asking others to do. A good leader never asks people to do things which they themselves are incompetent in doing or incapable of doing. So you must lead by personal example. And for this, I must narrate a story of an officer called Captain Vijay Thapar. I don't know how many of you have heard about him, but he was 23 years old when he went for the Kargil war. And at 23, you can imagine a young captain, he had the world at his feet, he had just joined the army. His father is settled in Noida, Colonel Thapar. And in this Kargil operation, they were launching attacks against the Pakistani army, which was entrenched on heights, overlooking the road down below. That is the Srinagar Leh road was under observation from those heights. And therefore, on these attacks had to go uphill and clear those heights. And there was no doubt, and he writes a letter to his parents the night before to say that by the time you receive this letter, I will be looking down at you from the Apsaras. I will be with the Apsaras looking down upon you. Because he knew he's going to die in the morning in that attack. Because like I said, most people who were attacking knew they were going to die. Why did he go and attack? When he knew that he's going to die. Because no amount of money, no amount of perks can give you the incentive to die. Nobody loses their lives for money. So what do you lose your life for? You lose your life for your honor. Naam namak nishan. You lose it for the respect. You lose it because you are a leader. He was a leader. He had to lead those men to attack. If he had not gone, they wouldn't have followed him. So knowingly that he will die, he went and attacked. And he died. And by the time his parents got the letter, of course he was no more there. So the point I'm trying to make to you is a leader has to lead by personal example. Keep it in mind, it will help you all through your lives. Please go ahead. Now when I joined the army 41 years ago, my experience in the army was that after the age of about 45, you're not expected to really be fit, which used to irk me. It used to irritate me that officers and men who are beyond 45 years of age are not expected to be so fit. There is no testing for them anymore. So I decided that I too must set a personal example in one day, one after the other, and to be completed within 17 hours. And if you complete it in 17 hours, you are titled Ironman. Please go ahead. So the event that I undertook was in Austria. It's not held in India. Now for the first time, a half Ironman, half to say the half the distances of what I flashed for you, is happening in Goa in October this year. Otherwise, most of the events of full Ironman are in Europe and the Americas. There are two events in Southeast Asia. So this is in Austria, and what you see on the top left corner is the swim rope of 3.8 kilometers. It's in a lake, and the last 1 kilometer is in a canal. Thereafter, what you see on the right is the cycling route, and those spikes that you see at the back are the elevations that you gain while you're cycling 180 kilometers. You also gain an elevation of approximately 6,000 odd feet. So you're going uphill. And lastly is the run of 42.2 kilometers. I'll show you a small clipping on this. And you take a look at that. And then we will talk about how an event like this can not only inspire other people, or it's an example of leading by personal example, but it changes your life, and we'll talk about that. Can you go to the hyperlink, to the center one, where it says Ironman, and please click it. Come see it. The audio's come on the
most seems impossible. For 35 years, Ironman has defined the sport, growing from a single race into a global movement and a new generation of athletes. With over 200 events, Ironman inspires us to reimagine our limits, to set our sights higher, to go farther than we ever have before. You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You can be a hero, you can get the gold. Breaking all the records you thought would never be broken. Do it for your people, do it for your pride. Statement of excellence, passion, commitment. It is a test of physical toughness and mental strength. Ironman is about persevering, enduring, and being a part of something larger than ourselves. It shows the heights that can be achieved when we push beyond our boundaries. And go the distance to earn the title Ironman.
So this is a small clipping of my event. Lined up before the race. And now you see 2,850 people starting simultaneously. Last kilometer, this canal. Then you run, get on your bike, and start cycling. Thank you. We never have time. I don't get time to do, say, my guitar classes because I'm in school. I have to go for tuitions. So you have to manage your time. I was working. I had a job 9 to 6 in the evening. I still had to practice. I would do it at night. Come back from office, change, go for a run from 7 to 10 at night. Try seat every time. There will be failures. So you mentally prepare for them. And if you fail, you attempt again using a different technique. But don't change your dream. Don't reduce the level of your dream because you failed once. A good leader is one who attempts the same objective, having failed from a different approach, from a different direction, in a different form. Optimism. You have to be optimistic, it will happen. You must visualize your success. So when you make a dream, visualize what will happen to you when you get your dream. How happy you will be. Your peers will be your family in pushing you through the training or the work it takes to reach there. Compete only with yourself. Don't worry about what your friends are doing, your neighbors are doing. They're doing this, I want this. No. Your dream, you yourself are your competitor. Plan it, small steps, those are the goals, and you will get there. And lastly, which I said earlier also, age is a number and anything is possible. So with that, I have come to the end. Next. If there are any questions, I'll try and answer. Mm-hmm.